Welcome to the show, everybody. It's been a very bumpy ride on the Canucks bandwagon of late, and with four more games to go this week, better strap yourself in and hang on. A 3-1 loss to the Wild on Monday dropped the Lane Vigneault's club out of top spot in the Northwest, and things didn't get any easier 24 hours later when the St. Louis Blues came to town. Canucks, just 3 wins in their last 11 games, 3-6-2 for Lane Vigneault's club. St. Louis, on the other hand, been streaking, trending upwards, have won 5 of its last 6. First period, Tom Sestito setting the tone early, sending Berrick Jackman to the ice. Love to see the body, and I don't know if you love to see this. Zach Cassian comes in with a bad back, and he's throwing haymakers with Chris Stewart. Cassian re-aggravated the injury, had to leave. Still in the first. Sedin, great seed to Daniel. But just loses a handle. Daniel can't score there. More physical play. Pinizzotto. Wow, into David Backes. Later in the first, Blues on the PP. Tarasenko. But Schneider robs Pietrangelo with the glove. Corey Schneider was outstanding in the first period. Blues keeping it coming. McDonald's initial shot stop. Rebound. Can't get it by Schneids. Getting that pad on it. St. Louis outshoots Vancouver 15-3 in the first frame. Scoreless after one. Second period. Mason Raymond starts the rush. You know what? Yannick Hansen finishes it. What a blast from Yannick Hansen. His 8th. 1-0 Canucks. Off the ensuing faceoff, Ryan Reeves tries to spark his club with a tilt with Sestito. They rumble, tumble, and stumble, and Big Tom yapping in the box. Maybe tell him to look at the scoreboard because it's going to light up again. Look at this beauty. Some Sedinery. Daniel Sedin down the slot. The Blues lost him, but he finds the net 2-0. His first goal in 9 games. They aren't done. Schrader, Spinorama, who is that? Is that Weiss? Dale Weiss, attaboy Weiser. 3-0, Canucks through 40, third period, Blues pressing. Tarasenko, it deflects off Jaden Schwartz. Man, the Canucks haven't had a lot of good luck lately, and that one bounces off a player and in, it's 3-1. Blues looking for more, and talk about bad bounces. Off Chris Tanev's shoulder, face, you name it. It goes right to Berglund. He buries it with his 14th of the year, and all of a sudden it's a one-goal game. Tanev would not return. He'd leave. Canucks lucky they got a late power play, and they would hang on. Corey Schneider, the difference maker. Vancouver with a big 3-2 victory. Schneid's outstanding in that first period when the Canucks were just peppered, and very solid in the third as well. When the Blues threw everything at him, the youngster Jake Allen, he'd maybe like a couple of those goals back, but I'm not sure he would have stopped them. We'll have post-game comments coming up a little bit later on in the show. But first of all, Gary Volk stopping by to give us his thoughts to break this one down, and a huge victory for the Canucks, Volkie. And I would say that Alain Vigneault talked before the game about how he needed his goalie to step up. Corey Schneider did just that.
Well, he did. It was his first start in 5 or so games, and he took over from a struggling Luongo. And yes, Coach V needed a big goalie performance. Corey Schneider had to outperform Jake Allen, and in this game he did. If you look at the first period, the first two power plays that St. Louis had were unbelievable, and Corey Schneider was equal to the task. Look, if you look at the first period and the third period, C-Mac, St. Louis outshot the Vancouver Canucks 28-5. Incredible goaltending performance. Yet the second period, the Canucks were dominant.
Yeah, let's talk a bit about that. I mean, not only were they dominant, those goals were a thing of beauty. And I guess for a team that's been struggling, they'll take them any which way. But they weren't dirty. They were just dang-alicious, a lot of them.
Well, the Sedins, for sure, were on fire most of the night with their passes. Daniel could have had a couple goals. He was the best player on the ice for the Vancouver Canucks and in this game, which is a great sign for Coach Alain Vigneault. Daniel was everywhere. He was all over, but Henrik, the master. Behind the net, in front of the net, Daniel in the net, his first goal in 9 games, and he needed that. The Canucks needed that. Hansen had a great goal as well. with Yannick Hansen. Unbelievable with him. I mean, he just keeps going. He's a Danish army knife that's been playing like a switchblade lately with the speed. But, you know, great pass by Mason Raymond and a tremendous. That's old school. That's Guy Lafleur-like in the old.
Off the rush,
how anymore. Does that go in? Unreal. Great shot. Yannick, look, Yannick should be shooting the puck any chance he can, C-Mac. He's one of the best skaters. He's got one of the best shots on the team. And finally, look at this goal. Tic-tac-toe to Schrader, stopping it up to Dale Weiss, who, by the way, played center in this game at times and was flying. He was one of the better Canucks last night against Minnesota. One of the bright spots, carried it over into this game. And, yeah, you know, that was their second period. Basically, that was the first 10 minutes of the second period. And then from that point forward, Vancouver, look, you got to look at the goals against the Corey Schneider. I mean, in the third period, a couple bad bounces. And you thought, here we go again. Where are we going again? Canuck luck is fading, C-Mac. But they hung on and prevailed. But they got outshot 13-2 in the third period, and Corey Schneider played huge.
Now, what are your thoughts quickly about Cassian dropping the mitts? Because the guy comes in with a bad back. You don't necessarily want to be throwing haymakers.
Well, it's the worst thing you can do is fight somebody because you're holding on to another big guy like Chris Stewart. It was about a two-minute fight, too. It wasn't a drag-em-out type of thing. They were throwing haymakers, a lot of wrestling going on. Look, Zach Cassian played 2 minutes, had two hits, and he didn't come back. And that's not a good sign for Vancouver. They need as many big bodies in the lineup as they can possibly, especially when you have Cestito there. You got Pinizzotto there. Canucks, by the way, too, C-Mac, quickly, they are now second in the league in fighting majors. So they are scrapping this year.
And they're fighting and clawing their way for the rest of this week. I know there's three more games to go, and Gary Volk will be in for all of them to wind them up and wrap them up with Don Taylor as Connected continues with the Canucks.